In the past few weeks, a number of Ugandans have returned from the United Arab Emirates, where they had traveled for work. According to Ministry of Internal Affairs, the returnees are beneficiaries of the UAE government's program to offer a waiver to 1,500 Ugandans living there illegally. Despite a waiver on their transport costs and living costs, only about 156 Ugandans chose to return home. Simon Mundei says currently there are over 100,000 Ugandans living in the UAE and only 25,000 of them are there illegally.
Ugandans living in the UAE, although only 24,400 are taken there through licensed companies. So you can see that we have about over 75,000 Ugandans who were taken to Dubai to secure employment, but these ones are doing it through fraudulent companies who are only looking for money. So only roughly 25,000 Ugandans living and working in UAE are doing it in legal means. The 75,000 are doing it fraudulently through some agents who are looking for money.
Recently, the UAE government issued a one-month ultimatum to all illegal immigrants to vacate the country or face consequences. Now, Ministry of Internal Affairs says if the 75,000 Ugandans do not vacate UAE by the end of October, they risk deportation or even arrest and prosecution.
These efforts, of course, to ensure that all Ugandans that have suffered this misfortune return home safely. So we are calling upon Ugandans who are living in the Emirates but whose visas have expired to report to immigration centers so that they can be helped to return home, because we have thousands of them who are staying there but their visas have long expired but they are living underground. Of course, once they are discovered after the amnesty period, that is after October, they will be fined and then thereafter will be deported back home.
Meanwhile, the police are currently stuck with over 10,000 national IDs recovered from Luigi Swamp during an operation against wetland encroachers in August this year. The national IDs were recovered along with 68 passports, 237 driver's licenses and 2 motor vehicle number plates.
Numerous identification documents from Terwana Hakim, and of which included the IDs you're seeing here. We were able to recover 10,722 national IDs. We were also able to recover 68 Uganda passports, 237 Ugandan driving permits. We were also able to recover some warrant cards, 2 motor vehicle number plates, ATM cards from different banks, among other documents that we have got. The Directorate of Criminal Investigations was able to institute investigations to ascertain how these documents and other items came into contact with Terwana Hakim, who is commonly known as Umaru.
Also, 2 police officers attached to the Ugandan National Roads Authority, UNRA, are to face prosecution on murder charges. They reportedly opened fire on a truck after its driver refused to stop. They killed 1 person and injured 2 others.
Who are charged with murder and attempted murder in a police-involved shooting which happened in Wakiso. This is an incident that we've been investigating for some time now. So it took the intervention of our Directorate of Criminal Investigations, which coordinated with the Kampala Metropolitan Police, to have these 2 officers charged for a police-involved shooting which claimed the life of a mother and critically injured her 4-year-old son.
The police chief, Martin Zokotho Chola, has further issued a stern warning to all police officers against shooting at moving vehicles if they do not pose an imminent threat. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.